In this video, we are going to see the topic is exponential distribution and it for the model 3. So exponential distributions, it will come under the topic of your continuous random variable. So as we have discussed in the introduction part, there is a two topic is there in the major one under for your probability. One is a discrete random variable, another is an continuous random variable. So under the continuous random variable, some two videos we did already for the some basics introduction of continuous random variable, and we have done for here finding the k values problem under for the continuous. Okay, so under the distributions for the continuous, here we have two distribution is there as per the syllabus. So now we are going to see the first distribution is exponential distribution. So exponential distribution is, let f of x be a probability density function, then f of x is equal to alpha into e power of minus alpha x for x is greater than 0 and 0 otherwise. So x only the positive, you have a function. The remaining cases it will go for 0. There will not be any function in the negative, where alpha should be a greater than 0. It is a positive. So this f of x function is known as an exponential distributions. Okay. So the next one, show that exponential distribution is a probability density function or probability distribution. So what is meant by probability density function? So we have to show the function is a probability distribution function. The condition is here, because of its continuous random variable, we have to go with an integration. So integration of this negative to the positive infinity of that f of x function should give equal to 1. So we can tell in the meaning of in the word, sum of that probability should give equal to 1, right? So here, because of a continuous, we are going with, that means uncountable, right? Going with the integrations. So let f of x is given function, what is that? Alpha into e power minus alpha x for x is greater than 0 and alpha is greater than 0 as exponential distributions, and f of x is should be greater than or equal to 0. Okay, because x is also 0, alpha is also 0. Now you can see first condition over. Second condition we have to go with that sum should be equal to 1, right? For that we are taking the integration minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to, here there will not be any negative function because positive alone you have a function, remaining as will go 0 as per the definition of here exponential. What is that? 0 to infinity, positive portions I have alpha into e power minus alpha x dx. So alpha is a constant, e power minus alpha x by minus alpha when you integrate e power minus alpha x. So it's 0 to infinity. So you can substitute the limit, I'll get e alpha will get cancelled, e power minus infinity by minus 1 and minus e power 0 by minus 1. So I'll get e power minus infinity, what is that? It will go for 0. And first one 0, then minus of e power 0 will be 1, minus into minus will become 1, I'll get is equal to 1. So both the condition is satisfied, x is greater than or equal to 0 and integration has got it equal to 1. I can tell f of x is a probability density function. Okay, then the mean and standard deviation of your exponential distribution. What is your mean here? 1 by alpha, and the variance is 1 by alpha square, and the square root of variance will be your standard deviation, that is nothing but 1 by alpha, as I told it in the last video also. So you don't have an derivation is not required, you need only for the result. So remember only the result of your each mean, variance and standard deviations. Okay, now we can go with the example. So what is that? If x is an exponential variate with a mean 3, and find what is that? You have a two question, x is greater than 1 and x is less than 3. So x is exponential variate, that means that you have an f of x function in terms of exponential variate. What is that? Alpha into e power of minus alpha x, where x should be greater than 0. Now with a mean is 3, here mean value, what is it mean of exponential variate is 1 by alpha. 1 by alpha is equal to 3 you have. Okay, so using that condition we are going to find a solution. So see the solution, x is exponential variate, yeah. So what is it mean? Mean is 3, so it is 1 by alpha is equal to 3. Okay, so what is your alpha? Alpha is nothing but 1 by 3. So substitute in f of x, alpha into 1 by 3 into e power minus x alpha. So e power minus x by 3 for x is greater than 0 and the remaining will be 0 otherwise. So now you can go for your first solution. What is that? X is greater than 1. That means that from positive, from 1 to you have up to infinity as per the general term. So 1 to infinity into f of x. Just you can integrate. I'll get 1 to infinity is 1 by 3 e power minus x by 3 into dx. So 1 by 3 into e power minus x by 3 by what is that I have? Minus 1 by 3 I'll get. I integrate from 1 to infinity. So substitute, you'll get e power minus infinity will go for 0. Then e power minus 1 by 3 is you will have an answer when x is greater than 1. Okay. So this is your first result. So similar, you can go for the second result. What is that? X is less than 3. That means that you have it the maximum deadline up to only 3. So from where it is, it should be a positive, right? From 0 to 3. That's why the integration has been done from 0 to 3. F of x dx. When x is less than 3, you can substitute f of x function 1 by 3 e power minus x by 3 and integrate and replace. You will get minus e power minus 1 plus e power of 0. So e power minus 1 will be minus 1 by e. I have written here e power 0 will be 1. So 1 minus 1 by 3. Okay. This 3, it will go up. It will get cancelled and substitute. You will get only 3 by 3 will be e power minus 1 and 0. You will get exactly this result. Okay. So x is less than 3 means 1 minus 1 by e is your answer. That's all. We have done your first question. We'll move on to the next problem. The length of the telephone conversation in a booth has been exponential distributed and found an average to be 5 minutes. Okay. Find probability that the random calls made from this booth first is ends less than 5 minutes, between 5 to 10 minutes. So it's related with some booth. Okay. Telephone booth conversation details has been given. And it's clearly mentioned as an exponential distribution. So you have to use with the exponential distribution of your f of x. And what has been given? And found an average. Averagely every day they are talking with minimum 5 minutes. So average is nothing but 1 by alpha is 5 minutes. So alpha will be 1 by 5. Okay. Find the probability that the random calls made is booth. So that means the call will end less than 5 minutes. Okay, so you can find x to be considered as in terms of exponential variate for the minutes, right? So x will be less than 5 minutes means when you are talking that in the booth. Okay, and you can see here given mean, as I told it, 1 by alpha is 5, then f of x is 1 by 5 into e power minus x by 5 for x is greater than 0 and 0 otherwise. So go to the first question. So x to be considered, you can take it with a less than of 5 minutes. Okay, that is the questions, right? The call will end of x with this less than of 5. Okay, so 0 to 5, minimum of 5 minutes. So less than of 5 minutes, maximum you have it 5. So 0 to 5, f of x. So substitute here. 1 by 5 into e power minus x by 5 is nothing but alpha into e power minus alpha x. Substitute and integrate. You will get answer is 0.6321. Okay. Then go with the second one. What is the second question has been asked? It's supposed to be a between of 5 to 10. That means x is varies from. The call will end from minimum 5 to 10 minutes. So integration 5 to 10 f of x dx. So 5 to 10, 1 by 5 e power of minus x by 5 into dx. So you can integrate. You will get from 5 to 10 for x is 0.2325. You can check from the calculator. You are getting whether the correct answer or not. Okay. That's a simple problems when you can go with the exponential variate under for the continuous probability distributions. Okay. So that's all. Thank you.